Hello everybody, good morning to all of you. Today in this video we are going to discuss properties of reciprocal lattice. Actually reciprocal lattice already we have discussed in the previous video. In the previous video we discussed three things. First, what is reciprocal lattice? Second, what is primitive translation vector? And third, one of the property, that is every reciprocal lattice vector is normal to a lattice plane. And that question was very important for degree 3 paper 7b group A students, as I told you in that video. So you may prepare or you may remember this question. You may remember this question for the from the examination point of view. Today again the topic which we are going to discuss, that is properties of reciprocal lattice, will be asked in degree 3 examination paper 6 group B. So this question is also very important. Today we will discuss two properties. One property, so that reciprocal lattice to be CC lattice is abscc lattice, and another part, that is reciprocal lattice to abscc lattice is BCC lattice. So one by one let us see how to prove this. Okay, so we are going to prove first, or we are going to derive first property of today's video, that is so that reciprocal lattice to BCC lattice is abscc lattice. Okay, since we have to start from BCC lattice, so we are going to consider BCC unit cell. So it will be clear from the figure. See here, this is a unit cell. Okay, this is a BCC unit cell, body centered pyramid. You can see there are 8 atoms at 8 corners. Second atom, third atom, fourth atom, fifth, sixth corner here, seventh and eighth corner. In addition to these 8 corner atoms, one atom is here inside the body, that is why you call it body centered. Now to get the reciprocal lattice, first we consider or we proceed by considering primitive translation vectors. We assume that A dash vector, B dash vector and C dash vector are the primitive translation vectors. And cube edge is A. Cube edge, you can see in figure, this is your cube edge, and in the cube, as we are aware that, or we know that every side is equal. So A, and that is I have written here, A is the cube edge here. Okay. Now, this is the primitive translation vector. Vector A dash is equal to this one, vector B dash is equal to, vector C dash is equal to. Now, next step, we will calculate volume. As you know, volume is vector A dash dot vector B dash cross vector C dash. Or you may write like this, or you may write like this. Now, here you can see vector B is equal to vector A dash dot vector B dash C dash. So if once we get the value of A dash and B dash cross C dash, we can get the volume. A dash is already here. A dash is already here. So remember this, it will help in calculation. Now next part is B dash cross C dash. See here, B dash cross C dash. it is a square by 2 x cap plus y cap. Actually b dash and c dash, we are going to set its value. This is b dash, this is vector c dash vector, and after cross multiplication we get this one. So now we know the vector a dash and vector b dash cross c dash, so we can get the volume, and volume will be this one. Okay, so if we take dot product here, as it is dot product here, after solving we get a cube. So the primitive translation vector of the reciprocal BCC lattice, A is equal to, this is the formula. Now B dash cross C dash is equal to this one here, A square by 2. So I am taking here, and in the denominator it is volume. Volume already calculated, A cube by 2. So after solving, we get 2 pi by A x cap plus y cap. Similarly, vector B star, vector C star, these are the reciprocal lattice vector, A star, B star, C star. Now, these are the value, and these are the value related to FCC lattice. So thus we find that reciprocal lattice vectors are just the primitive vector of FCC lattice. Okay. So this was about first property. Now we are going to discuss second property, means in bulk of the previous property. So that reciprocal lattice to FCC lattice is BCC lattice. So again we start in the same manner, but at that time in the previous part it was FCC, and now it is, sorry, in the previous part we have to convert, we have to obtain BCC to FCC. Now it is FCC to BCC. So method is same, but we start from FCC unit cell. These are the primitive translation vector, A vector, A dash vector, B dash vector, C dash vector, and cube is again A. So see here, this is the unit cell, this is the face atom, this is the another face atom, this is the, how many faces? As we know, 6 faces. So this is the face center atom of upper face, this is the bottom, this is the face center atom of the bottom, right side face and left side face, and this atom is of the front face, and this atom is of the back face. Okay, so now we take an origin, because we have to proceed for calculation of reciprocal lattice, and to calculate reciprocal lattice we have to first take origin. So we take an origin and we join the three nearest atom and take vector A, vector B, vector C. Okay, actually this is vector A dash, this is B dash vector, this is C dash vector. Now volume, as you have seen in the previous part, volume is calculated with this formula. Now we will get B dash cross C dash, and B dash is equal to this one, C dash is equal to this one. After solving with dot product we get this one, and now vector A dash is equal to this much, and vector B dash cross C dash just now, and after solving we get A cube by 4. So primitive translation vector A star vector 2 pi is equal to, this value is A cube by, sorry, this value is B, here A square by 4. So I write here, and this is the volume which is A cube by 4. So here A cube by 4. After solving we get 2 pi by A. And similarly star B star vector, C star vector, and here these are related with the BCC. So we can say that reciprocal FCC lattice vector are just the primitive vector of BCC lattice and multiplied by 2 pi. So I hope you have understood this video. Okay, thank you.